today is July 1st, 2020. My name is Father Trapp, and I would like to welcome you to today. As usual, I would like to remind you that we upload new episodes every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 6 a.m. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to be notified whenever new episodes are uploaded. With that out of the way, my friends, let's begin. Friends, today is all about understanding that life works on God's time, not our own. We all want good things to happen in our lives, but often we are not willing to wait. We want it now and not later. When it doesn't happen that way, then we are tempted to ask, Lord, when is this thing going to happen for me? Most of us, we need to grow in the area of trusting God instead of focusing on that when question. If you're missing joy and peace, my friends, then you're not trusting God. If your mind feels worn out all the time, then again, you are not trusting God. Sunday Adelaja, a Nigerian pastor, once stated, no one can change the timing set by God. Nowhere, my friends, can we understand about waiting on God's time than in the Old Testament. We are reminded of this in Acts chapter 7, verses 30, 32, and 34, which states, now when 40 years had passed, an angel appeared to him in the wilderness of Mount Sinai in a flame of a burning bush. I am the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Moses began to tremble and did not dare to look. I have surely seen the mistreatment of my people who are in Egypt, and have heard their groaning, and I have come to rescue them. Come now, I will send you to Egypt. Friends, we find it hard to wait 1 week on God, when in this text, after a long 430 years of captivity, God is finally sending someone to set his people free. Yes, you heard me. 430 years. These people were in Egyptian slavery. You see, friends, God, he gives us hope in this life that he's fighting for us. But he doesn't always allow us to see the exact timing of his plan. Although frustrating, not knowing the exact timing is often what keeps us in the program. I mean, let's be honest. If we knew that God was going to take 400 years to do something for us, I'm sure many of us would just say to hell with it and give up. However, when we accept God's timing, we can learn to live in hope and enjoy our lives while God is working on our problems. We know God's plan for our lives is good. And when we entrust ourselves to him, my friends, we can experience total peace and happiness. And I want you to understand something else. Even after being freed from Egypt's slavery, God's people still wandered in the wilderness for another 40 years. Some even said, Lord, we were better off with the Egyptians. And why did you bring us out here in the desert to die? However, friends, we must always remember God causes things to happen at exactly the right time. Our job is not to figure out when, but to make up our minds that we won't give up until we cross that finish line. The more we trust Jesus, my friends, and keep our eyes focused on him, the more life we'll have. Let us take a moment now and forget about time and space and place our focus on God as we begin and bring today to him in prayer. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, we thank you that you will answer our prayers in your perfect timing. Reveal what is in our heart, and make us ready to handle the answer in the right way when it comes. Help us to pray by faith consistently and long term, to believe, wait, and then move forward in your time. Help us to be patient in prayer, not give up, and trust you even during moments when we feel negative emotions. We don't want to live by feeling, but by faith. Help us not to take matters in our own hands. We choose to trust you, and we refuse to believe the lies of the enemy. We choose to be faithful in prayer. Deepen our understanding and give us a greater knowledge of what you are doing in our lives. We choose to hold unswervingly to the hope that we profess. Stretch our faith in the midst of the wind, just as you did with your disciples when encountering a storm at sea. We thank you that you have all wisdom and will answer our prayers in the perfect way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, trusting God brings life. Believing brings rest. So we need to stop trying to figure everything out and let God be God in our life. The best time, my friends, is always God's time. As usual, I would like to thank you for tuning in. And as we always say, make today your best day. Until we meet again.